Okay, this is sequences and series, part eight. It's the more challenging questions, this part eight thing. We're going to do it in two parts. I'll just see how long it takes. I'll take a look at my watch here and see how long this video takes. These questions are pretty tricky. I enjoyed doing them. Some of them really made me think, and they're really good to try. Well, here's the first example I'm going to do. This is question three all done. Mr. Autry gives us his geometric series. Here's the first term, 2 times 5 to the fifth power. The next one's 2 times 5 to the fourth power. The next term in the series is 2 times 5 to the third power. So it looks like the powers of 5 are going down. You're multiplying by 1 over 5. It's reducing. You're dividing by 5 both times. So R is 1 over 5. Now, the first question says, show that the series converges. When you see this word converges in series, write down R is less than 1 or greater than 1, because this is the conditions for convergence. Well, because R is 1 over 5, you're multiplying by 1 over 5 to get each next term in the series. Because it's a number between 1 and minus 1, that's why the series converges. So all you have to do is write this down, and you're explaining it. Then they say, find the sum of this series to infinity. So all you do is you go, okay, what's the first term, A? Well, A is just 2 times 5 to the fifth power. So instead of A, you put down 2 times 5 to the fifth power. What's R? It's 1 over 5. Then you just type this in your calculator, and you get 7,812.5, and that's your answer. Oh, that wasn't too hard. What if they said, just calculate the first 8 terms, the first 8 terms correct to 2 decimal places? Well, we put in the same A, 2 times 5 to the fifth power. Here's the formula, 1 minus R to the n, so you go 1 over 5 to the eighth power. Over 1 minus R. See, I just typed it into the formula exactly the way it is. I press equals on the calculator. Hey, I almost get the same answer. I get 7,812.48 instead of .50. Okay, the next question is a little bit tricky. It says, use your answers in 3.2 and 3.3 to determine correct to 2 decimal places this summation here. And it says the sum from 9, starting with 9, going to infinity, of 2 times 5 to the 6 minus n. Well, you know what? When I first did this problem, I didn't use 3.3. I just put it into the formula the regular way with A over 1 minus R, and I got 1 over 50. But that's not the way they want you to do it. They want you to be smart. In fact, they say we have to use these answers. Well, here's the two answers. Well, the first one is a sum to infinity. So that's if we started at 1 and went to infinity, we get 7.12.5. Well, the next one, but it says where this summation is supposed to start at 9. So it's missing from 1 to 8. Well, that's what this one was. It was the sum from 1 to 8. Well, the difference between the two is what this thing is here. It's starting at n equals 9 and then going to, because this is actually the formula for the whole sequence that we've been doing, but it's starting at n equals 9. So we're going to get our answer just by subtracting. And in fact, the sum to infinity for this this formula is just these two numbers subtracted. It's the sum from 9 to infinity. And it's, you subtract these, 50 minus 0.48, it's 0.02. And if you did it the long way, took the first term, figured out what it was by putting 9 in here, to use the same R and put it in the number, you get 1 over 50, which is the same answer as 0.02. I thought that was a pretty good question. And that's a lot of thinking for one class or one video. So that's enough thinking for one video. I think I'll stop right there. And